Okay, so here we are. Sunday, February 21st, we've got our 2.5 liter 4 cam EJ25D Subaru engine on the stand.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Camera girl is beginning to disassemble. What are you doing first?
I am still trying to take apart these little plugs.
Okay.
And you still did not answer my question.
Okay, well, you're doing a very good job, but you're a little carried away. Okay, let's plug that one back in. Let's not mess with that one, okay? These are injector plugs, and they will come off with the intake manifold.
Fine, how about this stuff?
Yes, you need to pull your ignition cables, okay?
How does one do that?
They just pull right out. Just grab a hold of them and give them a yank. There you go. Okay, now unclip them from here, and maybe here, and flip them up over and kind of put them up in the top here so they kind of stay up there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yep.
So, let's start here, and we'll work our way around. So basically what you have, take this bolt out here, and then this bracket with your wiring harness will come loose. And that'll be a good start.
Okay. What size is that? See?
That should be a 12 millimeter.
So why didn't we get a 12 millimeter?
We did. It's right there. I got to the whole set.
10 millimeter.
I got to the whole set.
Oh, well, the sockets. Well, you didn't say that.
There you go. See?
You did not say that.
Just as a general rule of thumb, try to use a socket for everything that you can because it will be easier for you. Okay, and as that is on reverse, not tighten?
Mm-hmm.
You sure?
Yeah. No, I'm not. Isn't that reverse?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, it is.
It may be a little bit too tight. Hit it. There you go.
Did you get me a little tub to put my little bolts in?
No, not yet.
All right.
But I will. You can just set them here on the table and we'll take care of those afterwards. Okay, so now you should be loose. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So that's good. That'll just come off with your intake. So you're basically done with that.
Okay.
Okay?
Now I do my little...
And we're going to continue moving ourselves around.
So these guys?
Nope.
No?
With this bolt, these two bolts, and this bolt...
Right.
The same on both sides.
Right.
We'll take those. That'll be the last thing we take off.
So we're not really working our way around because, you know.
Well, we are, as far as unhooking things. Okay.
Okay.
Down in there, behind, underneath your alternator, is your little plug for your oil pressure switch. That'll just pull right off.
This guy?
Yep.
Really?
Yep. Just pull straight up.
Okay.
Okay.
Fabulous.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Down here, right here,
mm-hmm.
crankshaft position sensor.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta squeeze this tab down and pull that back that way off.
Are you sure we can't just leave it there? It looks like a good one to leave there.
No, well, you can leave it there. It's gonna rip the fire off when you take the manifold off. Can I show you a little trick on these?
Yes, please.
See, sometimes what you can do is just go in with your little pliers. See?
Yeah, with no snazzier.
I didn't really have a good thing. Basically, just like that.
Yep, that's good.
And fold it off.
Okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So, continue on around. That's all free. Nothing there. Next thing would be our camshaft position sensor here.
Okay.
You can pretty much do the same thing I just did with that.
You can, huh?
Yep. Squeeze your little tab.
Am I squeezing my little tab?
Mm-hmm. There you go.
So.
See, look at you.
Oh, yes. Very impressive.
You're like a pro.
Uh-huh.
And just stick that up out of the way for now.
Do we need to do this one, too?
Nope.
No, that'll come off.
There's a few injectors.
Now
you got to pull these ignition cables. Give them a yank. Yep.
Guess I'm getting there.
Yep.
I just don't want to fall over backwards because I'll hit my head and there will be.
No, don't fall over backwards.
Okay.
Okay. So next up...
Now do we have to do that?
Yeah, you got to take off your EGR pipe right here. And you're going to want to thread this one completely out.
Okay.
And loosen the bottom one.
You said 17?
17 millimeter Lion wrench.
You don't say.
You haven't. Okay. So it doesn't want to go, does it?
That would be no.
Can I show you a little trick on breaking those loose?
Yes, please.
Okay, please take the camera. You're now in charge of the camera.
My usual position.
And the one thing that you can do, take this off of.
This is when the chisel would have helped.
What's that?
This is when the chisel would have helped.
Nah, you're very eager to chisel stuff off.
Yeah, chisel and chewing gum.
I'm very eager to have you not.
Chisel and chewing gum.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Up your... that.
Okay.
Okay. You go down here. Basically. Do the same thing. Mm. Increase your leverage.
Okay, I probably should have, you know.
Okay, of course, then you get your... whoops! Get your wrenches stuck together.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Okay. Now you're going to let me do it, right?
Yep.
Instead of doing it all yourself?
So now, the next thing that you can do, see, now that it broke loose, it's probably easier, is just you can use your regular 17-millimeter wrench instead of the line wrench, because you don't really need to do that. Okay?
Okay.
Oops. Sorry, shaky cam.
Or you could just use your fingers.
There you go. If you want to be rough and tough.
Well, you're not letting me use a chisel.
No, there's no chisels in engine disassembly. Today, anyways.
Mm.
Sometimes there is. But... actually, you know what? Go ahead and take the other end right off, too, because we're going to take the head off, so I'm going to just have it off out of the way.
Seemed like a good plan.
They're usually... you can spray it with a little bit of stuff if you want.
Oh, no, we're good.
Okay.
I'm tough, remember?
Very.
Uh-huh.
Unbelievably tough.
That's me.
Yeah.
Scary tough.
Beyond
tough. Okay, there
yep.
we go.
Okay, so you got that off? Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's see.
Now I can take my manifold off?
Next up, you're going to have... I'm trying to think here. Yeah, that's going to stay with that. You want to unhook this hose right here at the back of your... throttle body, this one right here.
Okay.
And then you want to unclip this little white connector right there next to it. That's the knock sensor connector.
There's room to work here. It's great.
Well, you know, it's a little grouch.
Okay, what am I... I'm doing this and...
yep, you can unhook that hose.
From... just pull it from
not,
here?
No, not that hose. The one next to the white connector.
This guy?
Yeah, the bigger one, yep. Under the clamp.
Yes, this is one of the ones that has the potential to shatter.
No, that shouldn't. That's a coolant hose. It should be pretty pliable. Okay. It shouldn't be too bad. Make sure you get that all the way down off of it so that it's not clamping anymore. The metal goes down inside the hose for a little bit.
Well, right, but... okay. And then should just pull off theoretically? I'm afraid I'm going to rip it.
No, don't rip the hose.
What?
Don't rip it.
Oh, don't rip it.
Yes, don't rip it.
Yes, alrighty then. You want to show me a trick? I know there's got to be a trick.
There you go. This is the way I do it. And as Ziggy pointed out, you know, we don't have any hose clamp pliers, but I never have. I don't know why.
Oh, you didn't tell me I got to use a huge dental pick.
It's not a huge dental pick.
Clearly it is.
It's not. And you just...
it would be great for removing tartar from like a mammoth.
Go around that. Kind of loosens everything up. See?
Dual purpose.
What's that?
Dual purpose. Crossover.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. See now it's all loose?
Yes, I see. That's fabulous.
Yeah. Slide it down.
Okay.
So.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now mm-hmm. you undo that connector there.
Okay.
Your next little Adventure. That's a knock sensor connector.
That's that little tab.
Yep.
Okay.
Look at that.
Snazzy.
Okay. Okay, let's why don't you go ahead and take your 8 bolts out.
Okay.
For that. The ones that hold your manifold on. 12 millimeter.
Don't fall on the motorcycle.
Don't fall on the motorcycle.
Okay.
12 millimeter, and then we'll remember everything that I've forgotten to unhook on the intake as we try to pull it off.
Okay, that sounds fabulous.
Oops.
Oops?
Yeah, you're fine. I'm just trying to get a good angle. Your hand is beautiful.
So it wasn't my oops?
No.
At this point in time?
No. It wasn't your oops.
Side?
Yep.
It's a basic now, okay.
No. Yeah, the ones for the fuel rail are right there.
I'm just being silly, I know.
That's the one for the fuel rail. That's one for the fuel rail. Thank you. You may need more of an extension.
I don't think so. So, this
mm-hmm.
one?
Whatever one. You can use the longer one. I think you can go. Got all this other junk down there.
Yes,
and if need be, I could give you a swivel.
A swivel. Did I just take something off I didn't need to take off?
Hmm? Cam position. Pretty good. See, you didn't need a swivel at all.
That's
not too
one.
Shabby.
Okay.
Okay.
Alrighty.
There's all 8 of those. Right?
Okay, where are we putting these things? We're just piling them up here.
Well, right now, just pile them up and I'll get a little.
They're going to like
bucket.
Roll under things.
No, they won't. They won't.
They will?
Okay, well, now you can just grab a hold of it. Okay. And look. Now, very carefully and slowly lift it up, because like I say, we're going to remember all the things that I've forgotten now. Okay.
Like back here?
Well, yeah, it could be anywhere. Could be anywhere. I'm sure I've forgotten something.
Like this here, this hose?
Is that hose going into something?
Yes, it's going from here to here.
Okay, yep. Okay, so we got to unhook that hose.
Where do we want to unhook it? Up here or down there?
Probably up there.
Up there?
Looks like that would be the easiest spot.
Are you sure?
Do you think? Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, That's a piece of cake. There's small coolant hoses that go through the throttle body on these.
Oops.
Oops.
Just a minor oops, hardly worth mentioning.
Okay.
It's not like a real oops. There's no blood.
No blood. We don't like blood. There's no blood.
This is the easy one, are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you positive?
Yeah. I mean, I
don't believe it.
Well, if you want, go ahead and take the other end off. If you feel that would be easier for you, then by all means, please try it.
Well, it's not sliding is the thing. I don't know if anybody told it it's the easier one. I think it missed the memo. Yes, it missed the memo. Okay, and there's our mammoth toothpick. Is this what we do?
Yeah.
Are we sure?
Mm-hmm.
It seems sort of like I'm going to break something.
Is it working out for you?
Oh, just splendidly. Splendidly, I tell you. No, I'm going to poke right through that. That's not a good idea.
Okay. Well, let's go about this a different way.
What am I doing with this guy?
Well, yeah, I will show you if you take this.
Take up here?
Yep. You can go up there a little bit. Get on it and just kind of give it a little wiggle. Once you get it turning, it'll slide right off.
Uh-huh. Yeah, obviously.
Is it turning?
No.
No. Oh.
The manifold's moving.
Well, that's because it's loose.
Well, there you go. I just don't want to stab something through that piece. It doesn't look like a good idea. It looks like it would cause future problems.
It would. And for a vehicle that, you know, we're just going to sell, we don't want to spend any more money than we have to.
Chewing gum, I'm telling you.
No, there's no chewing gum in these things. That's what the other people do. We're not like that.
Well, we could be. I could get grease on it. They'd never know. Okay, I can't do this. I don't.
Do you want me to get it?
Just a minute. Let me see.
Okay.
Maybe that is my problem.
Watch, don't stab your finger at that thing. You'd be very unhappy.
Are you helping?
I am. Could I be any more helpful?
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure. I'm going to get it.
I'm just curious as whether you're going to have a big hole in your finger by the time you do. See, now this is the stubborn part coming out of Camera Girl. I'm going to get it. Get out of my way. Give me a bigger hammer.
I'm going to figure it out. I am.
Mm-hmm.
It just doesn't know it yet. That's the problem. Nobody told it. What? What are you laughing at?
Your food. Is it turning?
No.
Looks like you turned something. Sure. Can I show you something else? Can you just let me try? Let me help you out. You've given it a valiant effort. Here, take this here for just a second.
I want to do it.
I know you want to do it. And you know what? The next one is all yours.
There won't be a next one, I can tell. It will be taken off of coolant hoses.
Okay.
So. Ah, that's almost a chisel.
What?
That's almost a chisel.
It's called a screwdriver.
See, I knew a chisel would come in handy. I knew it would.
There's your hose.
It's because I loosened it for you.
Yes. That's exactly what it is. Okay. All right. I think you come around this side. You can remove your intake manifold. Just go slow because we'll find everything else that I forgot. Is there something else?
It doesn't.
No, these should be loose. They're just hanging.
Yeah, okay,
this.
Well,
just pull them up out.
I am.
Okay. I'm just going to shut up and stand here and look pretty.
See, that is still attached.
Oh, yeah, another hose. That's a wire. Has a little clippy.
Well, then I'll come over here and deal with its little clippy.
The coolant sensor?
Sure, that's exactly what it looks like.
Yeah. See, it's been a long time since I take one of these apart. I'm old, I forget. Let me get this out of your way. Oh, there it is. I thought it was missing. It's not. It's just falling down inside. It's a plug that goes right there in that hole that you can see in the back. You have to take that out when you unhook the torque converter bolts, and it was already gone. So we figured it was just nowhere to be had.
Is that what we figured?
Mm-hmm.
So you got two. You've got this little guy.
What little guy?
Well, you've got this one.
And that's going to come with it. Actually, no, that won't come with it. It's on the crossover pipe. No, it just pulls off.
Okay, good.
That's the little, there's two thermal sensors here, and they're in that actual crossover pipe that your upper radiator hose hooks to. One, the one you're trying to unhook now, is actually for the computer, and the one you just pulled off is for the gauge and the dash. Let's see, I can just do that. Help you out. No, the whole brown thing comes off.
Yeah, I know.
Well, is it unclipped?
No, I'm trying to get to the clip. See, the clip is being not helpful.
Hmm.
Where's my screwdriver?
You want a screwdriver?
I don't know what I want.
Oh, okay.
I want a chisel.
You can't have a chisel. No chisels, no big hammers.
See, I don't... I'm just not really seeing the
little... The little clip's probably on the back side.
Yeah, I know.
No, actually, it's on there.
No, it's, I see it. It's just kind of
right.
Not very cooperative and happy about being a little clip.
I think if you just squeeze right straight on the end, you'll have success. Oh, okay. Well, if you want me to, assist...
All I have to do is take the camera.
Well, you just have to say something. So.
I just have to take the camera.
I can't see that. Hold on.
Just right there.
Uh-huh. It's just right there.
It's just right there. Just right there. See, it's easy.
That's it?
Just leaping out.
What is it? Just, it's hard to squeeze. And.
Yes, it is, isn't it? This is when we say I don't feel quite so silly.
Oh, you're not silly, don't.
Because, the experts are having moments.
There's no such thing as an expert. Did I tell you that?
Sorry for the angle, folks. I'm kind of.
And every time
stuck.
Somebody tells you they're an expert,
run in the other direction.
That means they don't know anything about what they're doing.
That is true. Okay, shall we try this again?
Okay, let's see what
third
else we forgot.
Time is a charm.
Oh, it'll be sitting on the floor in a matter of moments,
because
I can tell.
It's the third time.
Yes.
There.
Look at that! There it goes.
Sitting? Does it want to sit under? Or where
no, let's set that over there on the bench. Probably the best.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
Great, perfect.
So now
we're done.
And now it doesn't look like much, does it?
Looks like a big hunk of metal.
Okay.
Are these some of the gaskets for?
Yep,
fixing?
Those are your intake manifold gaskets, which we'll be changing. We will.
Yeah, well, that's the whole plan is to change things. And now I drop a bunch of gumballs down there, right?
This engine's been done before.
You keep saying that.
What has? Because if you look right down in there, believe it or not, Fuji does not install Felpro gaskets.
Sure they do. That sounds exactly like something Fuji
We're
would
gonna
do.
Install Felpro gaskets because those are the good ones.
Yeah.
Okay, so what I would do now, if it were I.
Yes.
I would get all this stuff here out of the way. This stuff.
Okay.
That'll just unclog it. So you gotta have a 14 here.
Okay.
And 14 here.
Uh
uh-huh. 14 here. Uh-huh. And they're probably going to be reasonably snug. Okay. Now, if I remember right, yeah, this one there, okay, come out. And then this one here, there's two 12s right in the front. Now it'll come off too.
Two 12s, why?
See, it's all going to come together because this bolt's holding it together. Okay. There's 12 here, 12 here.
12 here, 12 here. So I can do those first,
14
right?
14 here.
I could do the 12s first, right?
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. They're probably going to be kind of tight, I would think.
Okay. Well, then I'm not going to use the little hand wrench.
Okay.
Kind of tight, you say?
Kind of tight.
Okay.
Not that one. You're going to have to crack that one before you spit it out. I can see that now.
Where did that come from?
Out of the end of the thing. Oh. That's okay.
So how am I going
to
crack that?
Well, you're going to crack that by hand.
Okay.
That's what you're going to do. You're going to, you know, take something like, I'd give you that one, except I broke it. Here. Right on. Put that on there. It's better with a longer one because you do have more, a little bit more power, but.
Okay. And is that unloosened?
You want it off.
I want it off, okay.
Now, here's what I would do. I would take this and I would put it up on there like that. Hold it on the end and boom, boom, thunk it. Look at that. It's like a pro.
Okay.
You're going to be working flat rate down at the Subaru shop in no time.
Well, that sounds like fun.
Doesn't that sound like fun?
That sounds fabulous.
Yeah.
Really wonderful.
Remind me to tell you about the girl they hired in the shop one time. That was good.
She liked the girl at AutoZone or the girl at O'Reilly's?
No, she was like the girl at AutoZone.
Ah, well, that one
didn't really
well.
Didn't really know anything.
Okay.
She's the one that changed the oil in the car.
Uh-huh.
And was standing there with her hands, you know, it was up on the lift, and she's standing there with her hands up in there for the longest time because she had her fingers stuck between the block and the oil filter, and she couldn't get out. True story.
Okay, I think we're doing the whole thing again.
No, you don't have to. The two in the back. Here and here.
Okay, yeah, but that one hardly
has. Yeah, you're going to have to crack it, Liz. Okay.
This one here and this one here?
Yep.
Okay. And apparently this one.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, this is how people.
Probably gonna want a little extension for this one. The shorter one, I wouldn't get the longer one.
I can see how people get their little vibration injuries.
Oh, that's just a little thing. It doesn't have a lot of torque.
I'm just saying.
Make sure you hold it square on there and straight. See how you, yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay, I'm having trouble with this.
Okay, do you want to know how to increase your M4?
Sure.
Let me show you.
Okay.
You'll enjoy this a lot.
Okay.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to stop screwing around and we're going to get out the big guns.
Why didn't we do that before?
Well, you know, usually you can get them the other way, but if it's going to be, you know, that tight, that will crack them right loose. No problem. That will crack them right loose. Get on that, and you're going to snap that loose like a boss. Yep. Look at that.
Apparently so.
That's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
See, now you can spin them out with your little tool.
All right.
Your little tool will zip them right out of there now.
All right.
And we'll get your little tool ready to go here. gotta stay. You're gonna have.
See that? I'm gonna right. do something horrible to it.
Well, what happens if you do that? That's when you round the head of it off.
Yes, I can see that.
Okay. Now, instead of doing that, okay, think a little bit about it first. Take it off. Wouldn't that be easier to access?
But I'm worried I'm gonna.
You're not gonna move it that way. That's the dipstick tube. You're not gonna move it that far. And if you do, then, you know, there, see? I'll comment on it.
Super. Okay.
And see, now this one, you can probably just get, like, standing right here. You get one more.
Yeah, that one.
Oh, you did?
Yep.
Oh, wow. I missed all that. Must have been napping.
I already did that one, I think. Oh, see?
Yep. So now, all that stuff will come right off. Now that, we could just set down here somewhere. That's not going to be. Okay. Look at that. There's hardly anything left of it.
Okay. Next.
All right. Now, what I would do now mm-hmm. is let's get into our timing belt.
Mm-hmm.
First thing we got to do is take this off.
So that big guy there?
That big guy there.
Which is a what?
That's a 22, and there's no way that little thing in your hand is going to spin that loose.
Yeah, I'm going to have to use this?
Yep, and we'll see if there's any air in the tank. I think there is. I'm not sure. If not, we'll have to pump up the compressor. Right. No, use one of the 22 impact sockets I laid out. There you go. Yep. Big daddy.
I don't really snap on, do they?
Well, they do. Well, yeah, that's what you get.
Huh. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The hose is right there, hanging on the toolbox.
Yeah, but is it plugged in?
Well, let's see. If there's air in the tank, you don't need to run it. It's pretty noisy. If we have to pump it up, we'll have to shut the video off for a sec. I'm not sure how much air is in that. That sounds like a little bit.
Yeah.
But you got to have pretty good air to snap this loose. Okay, when you pull the black one back, mm-hmm. it turns the air off.
Right.
So pull the black one off. Pull that black one back. Now you just squeeze this one down. This one goes down too.
Ah, oh, that's what I'm doing.
Right. There you go. Look at that. Right. See, it falls right off because you've actually turned the air pressure off to it by the black one. Okay. Then up with the air one and you got air. Up with the black one.
Is that up enough? Yeah. You need to go up higher.
No, you're on. Yeah, looks like you're on. Weird. You'll know if you're not because it'll blow right off.
Well, I was trying to avoid that. Okay, and then
you want to go
this way.
Yeah, loosen. Okay. Hey, you don't have enough air.
Yeah, I guess not. Okay. It's not doing it our thing.
So I'm gonna shut this off for just a second. Let's pump up that tank. All right, let's try that now that we have some air. Okay. All right. Slide the black. Yeah, it'll just turn it off. Okay. Okay, now give that a little wiggle. It'll come right off. Very nice.
And
very
where
nice.
Is this being put?
We need to set that right there because we're going to put it back on in just a sec.
Okay.
Okay, so you need to take out all these 6mm bolts, which means it has 10mm heads. Around here, take this cover off, and then the center cover off. And there are some bolts. There's one, two, in the bottom. It looks like one's missing. Okie dokie.
Okie dokie.
And your little electric thing will spin those right out of there.
I'm sure it will. Okay.
You're doing very well. This is going quite well.
Kind.
And you're gonna remember all these bolts go put it back up.
You know, not so much.
Yeah, that's the way it's gonna have to go. Oh, that's what happens when you're not on nice and square. And you hit it with power.
I did that on purpose so people could see.
Oh, okay. See, that was a good demonstration.
Uh-huh, wasn't it?
Okay, now those both those end covers will come off now.
These two goopy ones down
yep,
here?
Yep, the two goopy ones on the bottom. Yes, those are the ones on the bottom.
Okay. Hmm. Yummy.
Look at you go. You're just piling up parts.
Okay,
taking names. Yep, four of them crossed up.
Yeah, that really.
Just leave it there. Don't even worry about it. No, it doesn't.
It's running away.
Now your center cover will come off. Should.
Yeah, I'm sure it will.
Yeah.
There's like oil in this one, but.
Yeah. Yeah, there's oil everywhere.
Oh maybe I
no, we
take
forgot
that one.
One more.
That's not four, that's five.
That's five. Told you. I'm old. I forget. Oh, look
at
that.
And then, look, the cover comes off.
Pops right off. Boy, that's going to be nice to clean up, isn't it?
Is this a gasket?
That's a rubber seal.
Okay,
for the cover.
Because it's tweaked and cracked and stuff.
That's
and
what
such.
Happens. Well, we're going to get a gasket set
There's
for
such.
This. And we'll have to see. Some of the gasket sets actually come with those, some don't.
Okay.
All right, so now you've exposed.
Look at the pretty belt.
Your timing belt.
Ooh.
Now, what we're going to need to do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Seeing that we need to take off the belts, we need to take off these pulleys.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I'll show you the best way to get those pulleys off. Those pulleys can be a pain in the neck.
Huh.
But if you loosen them while the belt's still on,
mm-hmm.
works a lot better.
Okay.
But the first thing you want to do
don't you
is...
you have to mark them or something?
Well, they're already marked. Okay? And we want to line everything up before we get too carried away. And it's actually just past its marks. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, what we can do... there's two different ways we can do this. As we can put that back on. That in just a little bit. We don't really put it on. Can we grab that for a sec? I'll grab us a special tool.
A special tool.
Oh, you know what? Maybe I won't.
Okay.
I packed all those up. Hold on. I'll get it out for you. Okay. Well, that's okay. We don't really need to. What we can do is grab our 17-millimeter wrench. We should be able to rock everything back. Okay. All right. Now.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, that worked out pretty well.
And you didn't need to unpack your tools.
I didn't have to get the special tool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now, get some glasses so I can make sure I see what I'm doing. All right. There's... There's a notch right here in this cover. Okay. That's already been marked with paint. And that lines up here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There's two marks down here.
Mm-hmm.
And they line up with the two marks on this one.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, this mark here mm-hmm. lines up with that little notch.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Okay.
There you go. And you'll also find that with belts and stuff like that, they line up, but not necessarily exactly perfect. They may be off a little bit. You just need to make sure that you're not off enough for it's one tooth of the belt.
Okay.
And the same thing over here. You got your notch. You got your notch. And they're lined up. You got your 1-2 and your 1-2 notch. Mm-hmm. They're lined up towards each other. And you got the one right here and that little guy.
Okay.
Okay. So now, if you look in the center, let the oil off on it. This is where people really screw up on these. As they try to line up some marks, they'll find back here.
That has absolutely nothing,
on the flex plate,
has nothing to do with this.
They don't have anything to do with this.
Okay.
Okay. The number on the mark on your crankshaft that you want lined up is that little mark right in there. Let me get a. Okay. Is that little mark right at the end of my screwdriver? There's a mark right there. See it?
Sure.
That mark right there lines up with that mark right there. See that little mark?
Okay, yeah, I do.
When those two line up, that's where your crankshaft wants to be, and your camshafts are in the correct position.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's the thing.
What is the thing?
As you're doing this. When you line this up properly, like that, what it does is it puts all four of your pistons about halfway down the bore.
Okay.
So they're nowhere near the top where the valves are.
Okay.
Because the valves on these can contact the piston. You don't want that to happen.
Okay.
And what you got, what happens a lot of times is when people make the mistake, they don't line that up and put it in a zero position, and they go to undo their belt, the cams will be loaded depending where the lobe is, and they'll snap back.
Okay.
And you could smack a piston with that. And I'm not really 100% remembering. I could be wrong on this. You may actually be able to hit valve to valve on these. I don't remember exactly. So anyways, if you line all this up first, regardless of what happens out here, you're pretty safe because there's nothing really there to hit. They're farther down in the bore.
Okay.
All right. So now we need to take all this apart.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
And I talked a little bit about these before.
Yeah.
These are a bugger.
Okay.
They're really tight and they don't want to come loose. The easiest way that I have found, and it doesn't matter, I'm using an air gun, but even if you're doing it by hand, it works pretty well by this way. You can just take them, grab a hole, oops, there, crack them. And just tighten back in by hand. See that?
Uh-huh.
What you're actually doing is you're using the belt to hold the pulleys so they don't turn.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. And once they've been cracked loose, even though he's snugged them back up again, they'll be very easy to take out when we want to. Because the one thing you find is if you're doing this in the car, you only have so much room, and then your, you know, AC condenser and all that's here. If you took the radiator out, if you didn't take the radiator out, even less. Okay, that's what happens when your hose blows off.
But it didn't happen to me.
It did not happen to you. Okay, well, we got them all loose. Poof. Wow. That's not any fun at all. Okay.
Don't put that up like that. I don't. I just worry about
that. Okay, so everything here is loosened up. Man, it does. You should sweep out here more often. Okay, so what this has is this has a constant tension hydraulic tensioner. See the little plunger right there?
Mm-hmm.
It's hydraulically pushing this tension.
Okay.
So it's set.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what we're going to do... super old. Doesn't look like it. We may be able to reuse the belt. That doesn't look too bad. Here's your water pump. We're going to change the water pump. But we may reuse a lot of this other stuff.
Okay.
Okay. And we got to look at your idlers here, the tooth idler and the two smooth ones in this little deal right here. I think more failures on these are caused from issues with these than the actual belt themselves.
Okay.
When you have a belt failure. So, all right. So, do the same thing. We're going to be crap happy. Those are all loose.
So why are you not letting me do this?
Well, you're going to put it back together, but this is... You got to do this right, you got to be careful with these cams. You really do. Okay?
I'm very good at following directions.
I know, but I don't want it to snap on you and whack you. Or...
Yeah, that would end my whole career right there.
I've
never come out in the garage again.
Okay, now, so on this side over here, the cams are loose. There's no tension.
Mm-hmm.
They're at that spot where they don't matter. And on that side there, if I remember correctly, the intake cam right now is loaded. It's got pressure on it. The exhaust cam does not, okay? See?
Mm-hmm.
See how it spun around?
Yep.
That's still sitting in the same place, but that one never spun around. So you have to be very careful with that. I've seen people get their fingers stuck in there and whatnot. It's a Gates belt. It's a very good belt. I still see the mark. There's another mark. There's another mark. I think we may very well. There's the dots. These may be hard to pick up, but these dots, see there's little dots?
Mm-hmm.
See, you see them, they're kind of faint on that. The little dots line up here.
Mm-hmm.
And then you go out when you get to your cams, okay? See, there's a mark there,
mm-hmm,
and a mark there. And they line up on the marks in the cam.
Okay.
And if we go all the way around, there should be two more little marks for the other side. Somewhere. There's one. There's the other.
Okay.
There and there. So, okay, we gotta be very careful with this. I think we're gonna reuse it. And as we look, always make sure the writing, this is the way the writing was on the thing. Because what you don't wanna do is, see, if you're gonna reuse a belt, it's basically spinning, been spinning this way. You don't wanna put it back on the other way. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So there.
Okay.
So we're going to take good care of this. You never fold it very tight and kink it. Just keep it all kind of loose. Okay, so now it's back up to you there, Lucy.
What am I supposed to be doing now?
Get right after it.
Doing what? What am I doing?
Okay, we're going to need to take our four pulleys off. Okay. Which we've already cracked
and
loose.
And this one isn't loaded anymore because it did it spinning and now it's
no,
done.
No, it's released and it's done.
Okay. So...
Your little thing will zip those right out of there in no time.
Oh, I guess it would.
I'm gonna take these and put these down here. So we get oil all over the floor. Right there. Get those out of the way.
Oh, that's not the right size. What size are those?
17. 17. Put that down there. Just gonna reduce some clutter. Now, here's the other thing I'll show you too. If you look on the, see how that says REX?
Yes.
Right hand exhaust. It tells you where it goes. Exhaust around the bottom, intake around the top.
As opposed to a large dinosaur.
What? Oh, Rex. And see that right intake.
Okay.
And the other one's marked left. So you never have to worry about knowing where these goes because they're so smart they tell you.
So we got to look at these because we might be getting new ones.
Yeah, we'll take a look at those. Okay.
All
right. If we have to replace those, mm-hmm. we'll just buy one of those sets where it comes to everything.
Okay.
We won't.
Including the
If you go to buy those separately, I think they could be kind of expensive.
Okay.
All right. So now what you can do is you can take out these 10 millimeter heads here, those three.
Okay.
And then the ones on that side, and then this back cover will come off. Yeah, I'm sorry, you're going to have to take them off up here, too. So there's actually five over here, these two here as well.
Where's my 10? Is it over there? Is that what that is?
Oh, that one.
Okay.
There you go.
Alrighty.
Cover should come right off. Yep.
All right.
And there's seals on the back of that, too.
Look at how pretty that is. It's not goopy at all.
Goopy. Yeah, it's a goopy.
Okay, so here?
Mm-hmm.
These guys, right?
Yep.
Okay. Are we replacing these things?
Maybe, if they come in the thing. See, that's the problem when the oil, there you go, oil-soaked.
Yeah.
They expand. They blow up.
Okay.
You gotta do that one. Yep.
Okay. That should be all of those, right?
Mm-hmm.
But is it slide back behind it or?
Yeah. There you go. Just like that. Should slide out.
Uh huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no problem there. Is that gasket stuck?
You're getting behind your. What you can do is you can take that bolt out of the dipstick tube, move that over a little bit. That might give you a little more room.
Take the whole bolt out.
Take it right out. Keep going.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's out.
There we go.
Let's see, now that I'll move around, that might give you enough. You gotta come past these three. There you go. Yep.
Okay.
Okay.
Ta-da!
Look at that. Wow, you're having a very good day. See that?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times,
mm-hmm.
those are stuck.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean stuck. Because see this little kind of like rusty colored goo?
Yeah.
It gets all the way down that the crankshaft stub. And this will not slide off there. And you got to fight with them.
Mm.
But you're having a very good day. Now... If you look back there, see that was leaking. That
mm-hmm.
was sealed. That's your front crankshaft. So actually, let me take this right out.
So you're having a really good
maybe.
Day until the end.
Yes. So So that was leaking pretty good right there. And we got to reseal the oil pump anyways.
Okay.
And we'll take the whole oil pump right out of there when we get to that point. The other thing we can take off is our tensioner. Get that off out of the way.
Right here?
Yep.
Okay. What size is that?
14.
Okay. Which I put back, right? I think.
Yeah, you're actually pretty good at it. It's the first short one. You're pretty good at putting your tools back. I've noticed that.
That's weird.
Well, that just goes with all these. It's kind of the same thing.
Okay.
Okay. All right, look at you. All right. Well, I think this would probably be a very good place to stop. And we'll call this part one.
Okay.
You've done well.
Yay.
And we'll be back and take some more apart. Thanks for watching.